Oh, We have come into this house, gathered in His name to worship Him. We have come into this house, gathered in His name to worship Him. We have come into this house, gathered in His name to worship Christ the Lord.
Praise Him and praise His heart. Thank you. first letter of St. John. He is the sacrifice that takes our sins away, and not only ours, but the whole world. I am writing this, my children, to stop you sinning. But if anyone should sin, we have our advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ, who is just. He is the sacrifice that takes our sins away, and not only ours, but the whole world's. We can be sure that we know God only by keeping his commandments. Anyone who says, I know him, and does not keep his commandments is a liar, refusing to admit the truth. But when anyone does obey what he has said, God's love comes to perfection in him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Christ. secondly, coming with an excerpt of a reflection that I'm writing, and I hope to have it out for next week. So I started by, so my reflection is pretty much me talking to myself and God. So do you hear it? You know, being here at this church has pushed me way more than I can ever imagine. Way more than the limits I've placed on myself. There have been many moments of aloneness and loneliness. Moments of questioning why I'm pushing myself. But in all those moments, I've never, to date, having accepted this assignment, regretted it. It's hard molding minds for the kingdom of God. It's a challenge knowing that none shall escape. So my ministerial nets must catch the child, the young, those in the prime of their lives, the ones who are in denial of their own aging process, those who are aging gracefully, those who are physically able, and those who are not. Also included in that catch are those of varying spiritualities, those struggling emotionally, financially, and physically. This reach also includes those who are far and near from the so-called reach of the net. That means I intentionally must risk launching out in the deep to assist and include them in the catch. But then, the funny part of all of this is that I can't swim to save my own life, but let others laugh out loud. But the mission states clearly that I must launch out for a catch. Also, my humanity and spirituality and spiritual health confronts me, because I do need to be ministered. I have my fears of the deep. I too, even though a part of the catch wants to feel nurtured and must not just be the catch. May I tell you, this God of ours is not easy. Him now listen to my cries. He, like Mary, just tells the people to do what he tells you. This God of ours knows me. After all, he's the one who creates me. And it's in that limitation, he has placed others to help in that pursuit. That wherever we fall short, others are there to carry on. The end of that is. Yesterday, at one of our meetings, our communications meeting, someone made a profound statement. He said, just imagine, it's just 11 men, 11 social disciples who proclaim Christianity throughout the world. It's because and through them, we have what we have today, a church of the living God. These were God's witnesses. These men who have experienced and have seen the scars of Jesus. And these men knew very well that they were part of that ordeal that caused these scars. They knew. Peter who denied him. Others who ran from him. And only moments earlier, Jesus would have said, do you know me? Do you know me? And they said, yes, Lord. Yes, we do. But it's one thing knowing and now living. That is a challenge. These men, these witnesses, as they go forth, they were the best that there is. But it is what they had at that moment. Today, as a church, it is what we have. All of us, we're called to be that witness, to help the other to reach heaven. But the second reading clearly says that we must stop sinning. It's not that resurrection was just a moment. It's a moment that must affect us right through our own life journey. Because these men who have experienced the resurrection rise above their own limitations, rise above their own insecurities, because here is a message that is true. Here is a God that came back and was willing to journey with them. Here is a God in the midst of their own wicked and sinfulness. This God says, come. As this God is saying to you and I, no, come. And it's in that coming, don't be so caught up in the things that we or I have done in the past. But how is it now, at this moment, how can I make right? How can I stand as a people and journey together? It's in that journey, yes, we recognize that, just as I said in the reflection, I can't swim to save my life, but others can do that. And those who can swim can take the lead. And those who are much able, they'll hold out that net for that catch to come in. So all of us journey and work together to build God's kingdom. Lone rangers cannot happen in the kingdom of God. Because for Jesus, we are his witnesses. We are the men and women, the children. We're called to guide and journey with a people. Just this morning, as I was sitting at the 7 o'clock Mass, there's this little girl, she's about maybe 5 or 6. Every chance she made eye contact with me, I whispered, said, "Do you run out to serve? No, Father. Do you run out to serve? No, Father." And this morning I said, "Do you run out to serve? Yes, Father." I don't know if you want to say to just get rid of me or what, but the fact is, sometimes in life, we must not give up. Press on. The same for your spouses, your children, still ask them, "You have come to church today? You have come to church today?" And they may want to say, "You know what, I'm come." Still push. Because that's why we're here. To build God's kingdom. And we must not just be confident and satisfied that I am in here and our holy war outside there. It's not about that. The holy war outside there, they do need to hear the word of God. In yesterday's meeting also, a question just come up in asking, what would be your vision and your mission and your objective as a person? And then divorcing myself as a person from the priesthood. And I remember writing down, I would love that by 2027, I think I put, that this church will have at least 1,200 members and more. That would be an awesome task. But it can't happen with me alone. It will have to be crazy people like me who are willing to go the beyond. Crazy people who are so in love with God that we work, and we work harder. Because now is a time, a good time to evangelize. Now is that day to give thanks. But that requires we have to go beyond our limits and see a God who went to the cross for you and I. A God who, arms outstretched, experienced nails in his hands, and yet he loves us. And yet he reached out to us. And there are so many moments of our own life journey where God is still saying, come. Because our destiny is not to wallow in the ground, but it's for us to recognize our own weaknesses and stand. Because every one of us, we are way more than our weaknesses. We're way more than our limitations. We're children of God. And because we are children of God, we're called to stand. And in that stand, yes, we have a bawler and a cry, because we know the hurt, we know the challenges, but yet God is saying, come. God is saying, come. Last week, Kevin Lou, at the 7 a.m. Mass, his wife is in the hospital. I invited him up to pray. And yes, he was an emotional wreck because he was crying also. And I dare say, yes. Because in this church of God, it's also a family. Yes, we will worship and we pray together, but we must be willing to journey with each other, knowing that once one member is sick, it affects the whole. That's why we gather. One of my fun moments was, again, last week, Wednesday. Here is a couple. Because of COVID and their age, they have not come back to church for the longest of while. But they have saved their collection right throughout the COVID period. And that collection totaled almost $500,000. So went to meet them. They're not technologically inclined either. So they're not really YouTube and all of those things. But the first time actually meeting them, when we spent what should have been half an hour, almost 2 hours, they're just chatting and going through and all of that. At the end of it, the husband said, Father, can I ask you a question? But don't feel away, don't feel obligated or anything. You can come back next week with me. I felt good within that here are persons, they're so energized about church because what I did, I was showing them pictures of the church, what we're doing, because that in of itself set some fire ablaze within them. I said, alright, we come back with a bigger screen for you next week. I'll bring my iPad and show them and go through. Because for me, that is proclaiming Jesus and church. That's what we need to do as a people. To set that fire ablaze in people's hearts. That not just in our own testimony, but the fact that they, through our testimony, experienced Jesus. It's a challenge. It's possible? Yes. It will cause you moments of bother? Yes. But if we're called to follow Jesus, if we're called to live that life with Jesus, prepare yourself. Just as this song, two white women on a minibus, and the conductor said, prepare yourself for the ride. So are we called to prepare ourselves for the journey with God. It's a God, my sisters and brothers, the honor and glory of Reverend Devil.
Amen. Amen.
I have made you too small in my eyes, O Lord, forgive me, and I have believed in a lie that you were unable to help me, but now, O Lord, I see my wrong. Heal my heart and show yourself strong, and with my
Amen.
believed on the wisdom of man. Oh Lord, forgive me, and I have responded to them instead of your life and your mercy. But now, oh Lord, I see my wrong. Hear my heart and show yourself strong. And in my eyes and in my song, oh Lord, be magnified. Oh,
Lord Jesus, as we recognize your presence in the breaking of bread, may we choose to be signs of your sacrificial love. Kindly hear the prayers we offer.
Your response, hear and answer our prayer.
Hear and answer our prayer.
Church, we pray for Pope Francis, Archbishop Kenneth, our pastor, Father Richard, Deacon Mark, all clergy, religious communities, and heads of ministries, that your Spirit will continue to open their minds and hearts so that they can share the message of hope with all who are searching. Lord, in your mercy,
hear and answer our prayer.
For the gift of faith, that you will deepen our faith and by the power of your Spirit, transform our vision and purpose for living. Lord, in your mercy,
hear and answer our prayer.
For all Christians, that you will renew our faith and give us courage to share it as you commission us to build up the body of Christ. Lord, in your mercy,
hear and answer our prayer.
For peace, that your Holy Spirit will empower us to be instruments of peace in this world that is full of turmoil and enable us to speak out against injustice. Lord, in your mercy,
hear and answer our prayer.
For all neophytes, that the journey they have started may be daily lived as acceptable sacrifices in your sight. Lord, in your mercy,
hear and answer our prayer.
For all the sick, that your healing power will fall afresh on them. Lord, in your mercy,
hear and answer our prayer.
For all the dead, that they may enjoy everlasting peace in your kingdom. Lord, in your mercy,
hear and answer our prayer.
For the prayers we now offer in the silence of our hearts. Lord, in your mercy,
hear and answer our prayer.
Prayer for families and vocation.
Our Father, in baptism we call thee by name, and make me a member of your people, the Church. I praise you for your goodness. I thank you for your gifts. Father, bless your Church with love. Raise up in Jamaica good and holy families, loving husbands, wives, devoted parents, and children. Raise up from our families and friends, dedicated and generous leaders, who will serve as sisters, priests, brothers, deacons, and lay ministers. Send your Spirit to guide and strengthen me, that I may serve your people, following the example of your Son, Jesus Christ, in whose name I offer this prayer. Amen.
St. Michael's Prayer.
St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And to God, O Prince of the Heavenly Hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the other evil spirits who wander through the world seeking destruction of souls.
Lord Jesus, through your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Help us to constantly follow you, the light of life. We ask this through you who live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
For
the preparation of our gifts, number 30, Alleluia, sing to Jesus.
Every nation has free.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exalted church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also the gifts we bring, that we may bear fruit in perpetual happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just to our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time of all, the Lord will yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all is risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land or people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, Lord,
font of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down and spread them like the dewfall, so that it become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which we give up for you."
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that, by the help of your mercy, be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus the Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Hallelujah. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Let us pray. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those your priests renew by eternal mysteries may attain in the flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. So good morning, everyone. Do we have any visitors with us today? As we stand and we acknowledge.
Wet him good, Mark. Wet him good.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Please extend your hands. Heavenly Father, we give you thanks, as we always do. For today, particularly, we give thanks to you for life. Father, we ask that as these, our brothers and sisters, celebrate the anniversary of their birth, that you continue to be with them, shine through them, so that all those that they encounter may see your love and know your peace. We ask this in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Come on, Deacon Mark. Let's go, Deacon Mark. This means they're celebrating 41 years of wedding. Please extend the right hand as we pray. For the family, for the gift of the life of this union, this marriage. We thank you for all that you have done, which is good for them. 41 years later, still standing, still basking in your presence. Maybe as it comes to live their life as man and wife, they'll always feel and experience your presence in their life. They have found always be there to journey with them, guide them, and strengthen their resolve. That as they journey on in God's and with God's. For as this, Christ our Lord.
Celebrate with me. The whispers have it
that there's going to be something in the hall after the Mass. It's supposed to be a surprise, but there's still some whisper. And now, because it's a whisper, we have to be certain that you're coming and you have an extra cape or something to bring, you better bring it just in case it happens, all right? So that is the spread. What I really want to see is many of you as possible come and stand. At the end of it, there's a song I want us to remember that we're singing this Friday for those who are coming. The pre-Mother's Day celebration is on Friday, May 10th, after the 6 p.m. Mass. It's a scare event. It's a scare night. So for those who are older than I am, don't understand scare, go into. If you can't, we'll have a week before we have a dance rehearsal to show you exactly what scare is. Alright? I probably asked Andrea to show us the moves, alright? But there's a song. But there is how many of us going back to our childhood days going to army? Perfect. Alright, so after our right step in the lead.
Thank you.